17, the Bible says that the Lord dances over you. In that original Hebrew language, it violently dances. Abandonment over you. He dances over his people. He dances. The Lord dances. So if he dances like a crazy man in this house somewhere, he just does something. It just frees us. I tell you, it just does something in the atmosphere. I don't want to come into a stiff, cold, sterile body of believers. I want to come into a family that is free, that dances and cries and laughs and prays and can dance together and cry together. That's just, Lord, it's a body. It's a body. It's a family. Lord, thank you for what you're doing here. Lord, increase. Increase your freedom. Lord, that the football stadiums don't get all the praise. Football players don't get all the praise. Athletes and performances, what you do. And we do crazy things for you. David danced. He danced, he danced, he danced. Ooh, and I tell you, we can't be critical toward the dance. We can't be critical towards the freedom of the Lord. When Mikal judged David's dance, he said, I'll dance even more undignified than this if you don't like that. When Mikal judged the dance, she became barren. David said, you won't bear. When we judge the spontaneousness of the Holy Spirit, careful. Careful. You just don't know what people are carrying and what they need. That's why it's just so good to be free. Come on. You guys ready for communion? Praise report. Philip ate 6 ounces of salmon and 1 cup of mashed potatoes last night and slept through the night. First time in 1 month. An elder in our church, and I'm wondering if it was your husband or your brother or your son, if they hadn't eaten in a month and just had 6 ounces of salmon and mashed potatoes and slept all night, you'd be happy. I'd be happy. It was my son and my friend. Lord, thank you. I'll tell you, stuff happens in dance. God takes care of our watches when we take care of his watch. Amen? It's good. Lord, thank you. Grab your communion.